Hi everyone, welcome back to PE at Home. Today we are going to do a 20 minute workout. It is going to be focusing on our upper body and core. So basically everything above the hips we're going to be targeting today in 10 different exercises. So we're going to go through 1 through 10 and then repeat that cycle so that we last 20 minutes in our workout today. We're going to be working for 35 seconds, resting for 25, and then moving on to the next exercise. Typically, it's going to be an upper body and then a core. Upper body, core. So kind of 5 of each, and then we'll get into the next round. Okay. So going to start off straight away with an exercise called the crab touch. So I'll get some music on for us. Crab touch. So you're gonna start in this position, so like a crab walk. Opposite hand comes up and touches opposite foot, okay? Make sure obviously you're getting back into that crab position each time. Working our triceps, the backs of our arms here. As well as our core, because we're kind of crunching over the side there. And rest. All right, 25 seconds rest. Our next one is gonna be a shoulder or a pike press up, okay? So for this one, you start off in a regular push-up position. You're gonna bring your feet close until you're in that pike. And then when you go down to the push-up, you'll be targeting your shoulders rather than your chest, okay? 3, 2, 1. So. Nice and easy down each time. Again, you should be feeling it in your shoulders if you're up in this position. So your backside's up in the air. Nice and easy. Lay yourself down nice and gentle. And when about your head gets towards the ground, you're gonna push back up. Feel that in the triceps too, and relax. Good, make sure arms are nice and loose. Got a quick warm up in before we exercise today. All right, next one we're doing is a crunch slide to knee. So we're gonna be on our backside on the ground. We're gonna be doing a crunch, which is that half sit up. Hands are gonna be on our legs. We crunch up so that our hands slide to our knee, okay? 3, 2, 1. So it's a good indicator of if you're crunching up enough. If your hands aren't reaching your knee, then you want to go a little bit higher, okay? Nice and controlled always with our core workouts. Make sure you're breathing. 10 seconds left. When you get to the top of that crunch, you should really feel your core muscles being worked, okay? 25 seconds rest. All right, next one we're doing is a high plank. So that's similar to a push-up position. Triple tap, okay? So how it's gonna work? We're in that push-up position or high plank. One hand is gonna go across and tap the other hand. Then you're gonna switch sides, okay? So tap the hand, switch hands, tap the hand. Now, inside of the elbow, and then shoulder, okay? So that's our triple tap. Try and keep your core nice and stable, not swinging back too much. You're gonna swing a little bit, but you don't wanna be all over the place, okay? And elbow, shoulder, shoulder. Hand, elbow, shoulder, shoulder, relax. All right. So number 5 is gonna be a tuck crunch. So we're gonna keep our shoulders up on this one. We're gonna bring our legs, our knees into our chest, and then extend back out. Okay, 3, 2, 1. So you're kind of being in the middle here. Try to keep your feet off the ground all the way out, okay? As your legs go up, you kind of flatten out and then curl back up. Oh, definitely burning in the core there. 4 seconds left, let's do one more. And relax. All right, that's 5 done, so 5 more in this first round. Next one we got is a Superman shoulder press. So to get in the Superman position, you're gonna be laying flat on your front. You're gonna bring both your legs and your knees off the ground and raise your arms and then press out front and bring them back. So you should feel it in your lats and your shoulders, okay? Then we go back down. So legs and arms up, press forwards, press back, down to the ground. Arms and legs up, press forward, bring them back in, go up to the ground. Again, feel it in our shoulders. And when you bring those elbows back in, you should feel it pinch your lat muscles in your back there, okay? Arms up, legs up. And back. Good, and rest. Okay, what we got next? We have got a bear tap. So kind of the inverse of our crab. Instead of being back in that position, we're kind of in a bear crawl position. And you're gonna tap your ankle, opposite hand to opposite ankle, okay? So make sure you got your balance there. Nice and controlled. You don't want to be falling over. Make sure your feet are slightly apart at the back. And relax. Alright. Next up, we got a standard push-up, okay? So important things, we're not slouching down too close to the ground. We're not up in that pike position. Find that straight back. Lower yourself down nice and controlled, but stand up. 5 seconds rest. 3, 2, 1, let's go there. Nice and easy. As always, if you're struggling to do a push-up, you can modify it, go down onto your knees. You still work on your chest and triceps. Okay? You can on this first round. Let's get our full push-up performance. Three seconds left, let's do one more. Good. Whoa, shake off those shoulders. And those triceps, definitely feeling it there as well. All right, next one we got is flutter kicks. So we're gonna be laying on our backs and then kind of like we're swimming in the pool, about 6 inches off the ground, you're gonna keep your heels and flutter those feet. Make sure you're breathing in between. All right, so to flatten our backs, I like to put my hands underneath my back and then nice little controlled kicks. Try and keep your feet off the ground the whole time. Stay your breath back at this point. Nearly at the end of round one. Three, two, one. Last one we got is a tricep dip. So, 2 ways we can do this. If you've got no bench or seat or couch around you, you're gonna get in that crab position from the first exercise. Lift your hips up, bend and extend at the elbow, okay? If you've got a couch or something, you can do the same thing. and it allows you to dip a little further down, okay? Because where the camera's set up, I'm going to do it just on the ground. All right. Nice and controlled. So you're not moving your hips are only moving because you're bending and extending at the elbow there. Try and keep your elbows tucked in. Really concentrate the movement on those triceps, the back side of your arm. You're doing it right, it should be burning. All right, and rest. So, 10 exercises done. We're gonna repeat through each one more time, and then we'll have 20 minutes in the bank, upper body and core workout done for the day. So, crab tap as our first one. Grab a drink if you need it. Shake those arms up if you need it. All right, so down on the ground. Similar to that, tricep dip. Shouldn't put them back to back. It's gonna burn out our arms there, but we'll keep pushing through. Opposite hand, opposite leg. A little bit of coordination. Some core stability in the middle. And calves, our arm strength keeping us up at the back. 7 seconds left. Try not to drop. And relax. All right. Exercise number two, we've got that pike or shoulder push up, okay? Nice job if you're keeping up with me. If you're taking breaks in between, that's fine also. Let's keep getting through this workout together. All right, so walk yourself up into that pike. And bring yourself down. And up. If you're not feeling it in your shoulders, work your way up a little bit more. Oh, the burn is real. Let's get one more in. We've got 5 seconds left. And again. And rest. Whew, sweating. All right, we've got our crunch. Slide up the knee, okay? 10 seconds, get your breath back. Breathing is so important. Keep those lungs nice and open. Inhale and exhale. All right, so now we've got our shoulders on the ground. Then as we come up, we're sliding our hands up on knee. Breathe in as you come down. Exhale. Just go back up. And relax. Cool. That 25 seconds rest goes quick, doesn't it? Alright, we've got our high plank triple tap. So that's hand, elbow, shoulder. Switching out each time. Let's keep working. Nice job so far. Alright, so we're in that upright plank, hand to hand, hand to elbow, or inside of the elbow, shoulder, and then back at the bottom. Triple tap. Let's keep working, nice job. One more round through. Alright. Okay, where are we at now? Top crunches. These are killer for me. Definitely something I need to work on, my core strength. Might have to take a rest in between these ones, but keep pushing through if we can. Breath back. Alright, Slow knees to chest, and then we extend back up. Oh, the burn is real. 12 seconds left. Nice and controlled. If you can only do one or two at a time, that's fine. Keep that technique. All right, and rest. We got through it. All right, we got our Superman and then our shoulder press. So there's a lot to explain on this one. So where you want to be feeling it is as you bring your shoulders up, we're crunching back in, and you should feel it in your lats here, okay? So kind of like the side of your back. All right, remember our knees and feet come up, and that's Superman, and then we're back down, okay? Nice and controlled. Really focus on pinching those muscles in when you get back here, okay? And then just holding this position up like this should be working our core as well. And relax. Alright. Nearly there. Couple exercises left. Four to go. Alright, we've got our bear tap. So up in that bear crawl position, opposite hand to opposite ankle going across your body. Let's go, come on, nearly done. So we're up in that position. Nice and slow, okay? This is not one you want to do as fast as you can, especially if you're on a carpet with socks like me. You're going to be slipping all over the place. If you're struggling, you can just go knee across the body, similar motion, and relax. All right, we've got our push-ups. Shake off those arms, last couple. We can push through it together, okay? Then you're done. You've done 20 minutes, high intensity intervals, working lots of different muscles. Burning some calories. All right, push-ups. Go modified if you need to. Gonna get that chest to floor each time. All right, 15 seconds left. Let's try and get five more. One, two, three. Four, last one. And five. Woo. Oh, definitely feel it in my shoulders, in my chest. Good upper body workout. All right, last two. We got our flutter kicks and then tricep dips to finish. Let's finish strong, okay? Don't give up. Keep powering through and then you can rest all you need after. All right, so flutter kicks. We're down on the ground. And then we're just doing those nice little kicks, aiming to have some endurance in our core and our abdominal muscles here, keeping our heels off the ground. 15 seconds left. Keep those legs up. You can do it. And relax. Woo. Oh, that sweat in my eyes. It means we're working hard. Let's keep going. Last one. Tricep dips. You've got that seat that you can lean on. Go ahead. Make sure it's stable. If not, we can do them on the ground just as good. So make sure your fingers are pointing forward underneath you. We go up, hips up, bend and extend. Okay. Find that position with your hands that's comfortable, that you can get a good deep bend, and then extend up. Whether that means bringing your hands a little more towards your body or further away. Again, we're just moving our arms here, bend and extend. The rest of your body should move with it. One more. And relax. Oh. Oh, that took a lot out of me there. Nice job if you kept tight the whole way. If you only managed 10 minutes and you did one round through, that's still awesome. You've worked your body, you've been active, you've burned some calories. So keep it up, stay healthy. Hopefully see you again for another workout soon.